What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to a special edition of Locked In Sports, bringing you my five best bets for the WNBA All-Star Game. That's right, it's All-Star season in the WNBA. We've got a really, really exciting game coming up. A lot of personal grudges, a lot of feuds, just a lot of stuff going into this game that I think is going to lead to some really exciting gameplay and a few picks that I'm really confident in. And if you're not someone who generally watches the WNBA, honestly, I'd say this is a great first game to start with. There's a lot of storied history going into this game, a lot of season-long rivalries that are going to play out here that I'm excited to watch and I'm excited to capitalize on with our picks for today. Now, why am I calling this a special edition? Well, the video's going to be a little bit different. We just got five straight player props for today. No total points lines to talk about. No recap of a previous video, because the recap for the last video, a NBA Summer League video, is going to be talked about in our next NBA Summer League Best Bets video coming out sometime in the near future after this video drops. Maybe out right now as you're watching it. If it's not out, well, then subscribe, turn on notifications so that you know when it drops so you can also place some great bets on the NBA Summer League. That being said, leave a like as well and comment down below with your own picks and parlays, what players you'd like from this game, if you think, you know, Angel Reese or Caitlin Clark is going to have a better showing, because that should be a really fun matchup. And although they're playing for the same team, and although they both, or as though Angel Reese said she's excited to play with Caitlin Clark, I'm expecting a lot of animosity there. Really excited to watch it play out. But let's hop into my five best bets for the WNBA All-Star Game. Before I hop into my first pick, just want to let y'all know that because this is an All-Star Game and there isn't as much data to go off of, of course, I looked at how these players have been playing for the season, how they've been playing recently, and a lot of other stuff, but it's much harder to predict with facts and data, which is what I normally prioritize using my videos, what I really rely on, just because these are team constructions that we've never seen before. These are matchups that we've never seen before. This is a style and atmosphere of play that we've never seen before. So I might not have as much cold hard data to back up these picks, but I think I've got a lot of good reasoning for each and every one of them that I'm, of course, going to explain. Also, Underdog Fantasy, the app that I bet on, that I get my lines from, that I use my on-screen graphics, isn't doing straight up and down bets for this game. They're doing just a series of alt lines that you can take hires on only. So graphics might look a little different, and the lines that you're getting on your sportsbook may be a little different from the ones that I'm portraying on screen, because I don't know if every sportsbook is doing lines the same way that Underdog is. So just letting y'all know that. Use your own discretion for these picks. You know, if I take an over, you know, 10.5 points and you look on your sports book and it has 11.5 instead, use your discretion. You know, if you want to take a different outline, go ahead. I'm going to say my reasoning. Take what you want from that. And yeah, no, that was a bit lengthy, but just want to let y'all know all that so you can make the best, well-educated and well-informed picks that you guys possibly can. So with all that out of the way, top of my first pick, it's someone who's got a lot of stake in this game. It's Angel Reese for over 14.5 points. Why? Well, should be kind of obvious, dude. Her and Caitlin Clark have a huge rivalry. And even if Angel Reese tries denying it publicly, like, we all know what's going on. She's going to do everything she can to outplay Caitlin Clark. I think that's just what's happening. Look, and she's been averaging 13.5 this season, but now she's in a game where she's going to be a main source of offense. It's going to be a much different atmosphere, an atmosphere where I think she'll have a lot more opportunity to score, an atmosphere that I think will play well to her just kind of driving the basket, making shots, and doing everything she can to outperform Caitlin Clark. And a main part of that is going to be trying to score more points than Clark. So I see both of them going very high on their points. We'll talk about Clark in a bit, but I'm locking in Angel Reese for over 14.5 points. Next up, let's hop to the player I was just talking about, Caitlin Clark. I'm taking her for over 19.5 points. Quite a few more than Reese. Why? Well, she's averaging a lot more than Reese. 17.1 this season, but I think this is a game where she sees even more shots. And the fact of the matter is, people want to see Caitlin Clark shoot, and she knows that. And she's got a lot to prove as well. She was snubbed from Team USA, so huge diss there that I think she's going to try to show Team USA why they were wrong. And I really anticipate Clark being the highest scorer on her team. Also, she's got that rivalry with Reese I was talking about. I don't know if Caitlin Clark cares about it as much as Angel Reese does, but I do not think that in any world Clark is going to let Reese outscore her. I easily see Clark going over 20 points. So I'm taking her for over 19 and a half. Next up, this is actually a really easy line, and it's Jonquil Jones for over 6.5 rebounds. This line's weirdly low. Because she's averaging 9.2 this season, so 6.5 feels like a easy gimme. Her and Angel Reese are going to be the main two rebounders and the main two players in the paint for the WNBA team. And I think, yeah, Reese will get a lot of rebounds, but I think Jonquil Jones definitely goes over 6.5. She's got the seniority there. She's got the leadership experience. I think there's going to be a lot of times when missed shot comes down, Reese or Jonquil could grab it. I think Jonquil grabs it. Takes the ball up the court, starts facilitating the offense because she's more of a veteran presence there. And even if Reese does grab a lot of rebounds too, Jonquil Jones only needs 7. She's a center forward. She's in the paint. She's going to be grabbing a lot of rebounds. Like I said, she's averaging 9.2. Just really easily locking in Jonquil Jones for over 6.5 rebounds. Next up is a player that needs no introduction. It's another rebounds line. It's Asia Wilson for over 9.5 rebounds. Man, what do I need to say about this? Like, she's averaging 11.9 boards this season. Her line being at 9.5 feels almost insulting. Also, she's the main center slash forward. Different places have her listed at different positions, but she's a paint player. She's the main paint player for Team USA, which is filled up with a lot of guards and a lot of forwards who play more of a perimeter role. I think Asia Wilson's going to be in the paint a lot. She's going to be pulling down a lot of boards. And I think everyone on that team knows that she probably should be the one with the ball in her hands. She probably should be the one facilitating their offense. So I see them just kind of leaving a lot of rebounds to Asia Wilson and letting her pull down tons of boards, running the offense through her. Yeah. If you want to take her for a points line, either her regular or an alternate line, I like that as well. But I think that there's a world where she facilitates more than she scores. But there's no world where she doesn't go over 9.5 rebounds. Last up for my fifth and final pick, it's another Team USA player and an MVP contender, Breonna Stewart, for over 14.5 points. This is weird. Look, she's averaging 19.3 this season. Having her line at 14.5 is wrong, feels criminal. And I get it. She was out for a few games, and that's worrying because what if she's not fully healthy? I would be concerned if her coach hadn't come out and said she was fully healthy and could have played last game, but they didn't need her to win, so they just opted to play extra safe, rest her. That was over a week ago. She was good to play a week ago. They rested her extra to be safe. Now she's had a week more to recover. Come on. She's going into this game fresh. She's going into this game healthy. And she's going into this game as one of the best players and best scorers in the league. Yeah. She's good at what she does. It's Breonna Stewart. She's averaging 19.3. Come on. I don't think Team WNBA has the defense or the paint player strength to stop Breonna Stewart from just dominating them off the, not off the board, but dominating them in the paint. And with layups and just come on. She's averaging 19.3 points. I don't need to say any more. Breonna Stewart for over 14.5 points. All right, there you have it. Those were my five best bets for the WNBA All-Star Game. Thank you all very much for watching. Don't have anything else for the end of the video. No total points lines. Just want to say thank you all very much for the support on the channel for watching this video. I've been talking mostly about the NBA, so curious to see how well a WNBA video does, but I'm thinking about making some more WNBA videos once the season starts up again after the Olympics and the NBA Summer League's done, and we're still waiting for football. So let me know if that's something that you guys want to see. If you like this WNBA video, if y'all are into the WNBA as well, I've been watching it a good amount. I just haven't made any videos on it yet, so if you want to see me talk about it more, let me know. Be happy to. And yeah. If you're new to the channel and you like the picks, you want to make money with us, then subscribe. Hit the notification bell, turn on notifications so that you know when videos drop, because the sooner you watch, the sooner you get your lines. And generally, lines like to shift later on and get worse. So, better lines you're going to get. Leave a like, comment down below, and all that. Yeah. Also, I know I'm a bit more low energy this video than I usually am. That's because I'm filming this really late at night, and I film most of my videos in the morning, where I can be a lot louder and have a lot more energy, but wanted to get this video out at night rather than in the morning, just so that y'all have more time to watch it, more people can see it, and yeah, felt better to get it out earlier rather than later. So, thank you all again very, very much for watching. Hope you guys enjoy the WNBA picks. Have a good one, and let's make some money. Yeah.